years. Students, in this video, we shall clear about the two phenomena of the revolution of the earth, that is the summer solstice and the winter solstice. So now, come to know, you will see the image. It is also given in the book, the figure 3.3, in which the whole structure is given and how the earth revolves around the sun and how the season changes. Student, if you will see, according to the figure 3.3, on 21st June, the north hemisphere is tilted towards the sun. Student, if you will see that image and the position of the earth here, on 21st June, the earth's inclination is on the most towards the sun. If you will see, this is the North Pole and this is the Arctic Circle, and it is inclined towards the sun. And because of its inclination towards the sun, the region receives most of the heat, and that is in that region we can see summer. Now, students, if you see the poles, poles receive a very less heat because of the slanting rays of the sun. You know very well, because of its circular shape, sun's rays cannot reach at its straight way. It reaches in a slanting way, that's why it region receive less heat. Now, move to the next point that because of the inclination of the North Pole towards the sun, Arctic Circle, you will see Arctic Circle experience continuous daylight. Friend, look, this is Arctic Circle, and you will see because of the inclination of the earth towards the North Pole, it is North Pole and it is tilted towards the sun, so that's why it receives straight sunlight, and because of it, it experiences continuous daylight. And instead, it is very surprising to know that receives continuous daylight at least 6 months. Imagine, it means that at the period of 6 months,
in topic of cancer,
there is no light. It means that it receives continuous daytime light and it always occurs day for the 6 months. It means that days are 6 months during summer. Now, children, it is the summer in the north of the equator. It means that because of the inclination or the tilt toward the sun, now cancer or such condition, it is known as summer solstice. Today, summer solstice you can define as the condition when the north pole inclined towards the sun at its maximum point, meaning that the inclination of the earth at its most or the midsummer, in the midsummer at this region, and sun rays falls directly on the most of the region in northern hemisphere. So it is known as summer solstice. Now go to the next point. Now student, the same condition will happen in the other side of the earth. If you will see, on the other hand, on 22nd December, the tropic of Capricorn receives direct sun rays as the south pole on tropic of Capricorn at 23.5 degrees. And if you will see the other portion of the figure of 3.3, in which you can see on 22nd December, this is the region when on 22nd December, the tropic of Capricorn receives direct sun rays. Look, this is the region that is symbolized the tropic of Capricorn, and it receives direct sun rays, and the greater portion of the south pole receives direct sun rays, and that is why there is summer in southern pole or southern hemisphere. Student, here you can also see that the days are longer and the nights are shorter as well as in the northern hemisphere during 21st June or in summer. Student, the same condition reverse happens in northern hemisphere, meaning that the condition which we see in southern hemisphere or at tropic of Cancer, the same reverse condition happen or opposite condition happens in the northern hemisphere or at tropic of Capricorn. Today, this position of the earth is called winter solstice. It means that the winter solstice is the solstice when the inclination of the earth is maximum, is in its tilt away from the sun. It means that when the earth inclination away from the sun at its maximum point, it is winter solstice, and in that time face continuous daylight, and at that time the northern hemisphere or the northern pole face continuous night time. So student, this is the point. Now students, you will see the question that, do you know that Christmas is celebrated in Australia in summer? Student, you know, when